the fifth ICC World T20. Let's look at all the contenders, but let's look at the former champions first. Now, let's look at the West Indies first. Defending champions, can they win it again? Sometime back, if you had said, listen, the World T20 is on the subcontinent, you'd have said West Indies, no chance. But something has happened in the last 5 or 6 years, and the West Indies are now producing bowlers, for example, who are not fast and who actually like the slower tracks. Remember, they won in Sri Lanka. Do they have the X factor players? Chris Gayle, he's the most colossal X. Dwayne Bravo, Darren Sammy, Sunil Narayan. What's the one plus all these people have? They are day in, day out IPL season players. They play every day virtually in the IPL. And so they know the conditions very well. They know how to bowl there. They know the boundary lengths. They're masters of the subcontinent. In fact, Dwayne Bravo has played even in Bangladesh, if I remember right. So they've got these four or five players. But what of the support cast? It doesn't inspire a lot of confidence, to be honest. So the West Indies are a decent side. They'll have enough spin bowlers. But will they defend their title? Let me just say that if they do defend their title, there'll be celebrations all over the Caribbean. So, not in my list of top two or top three teams at the moment. Then let's move on, England. Can England play on the subcontinent? Are England convinced that they can come here and win a T20 on the subcontinent? I think that is the key. We might all think, yeah, England, good side. You look at it on paper, yeah, they've got decent seamers, they've got decent all-rounders. They've got people like Hales and Wright and Morgan who are good T20 players. Bupara does a little bit of both subcontinent style of player. And you might think, yeah, they've got it. In fact, one of the things about this T20 is that any of 8 teams can win it. It's even more open than FIFA. So, but can England do it? They're the slow bowlers to go ahead and win it. Because I suspect the tired wickets in Dhaka, I don't know how the wickets are going to be in Chittagong. I just worry a little bit about England going all the way. As I said, neither West Indies nor England in my top three. And then to the team that makes everyone just go a bit like this. Right, let's watch. Pakistan. What kind of team is Pakistan? I've watched them very closely in the Asia Cup. Even Pakistan don't know which Pakistan is going to turn up. And I saw all the Pakistans in the Asia Cup. When they're playing well, Mohammad Hafeez, all-rounder, 4-overs bowler. Shahid Afridi, number 7, 4-overs bowler. Umar Akmal, number 6, can keep wickets. How many teams in the top 6 or top 7 have a wicketkeeper and 2 bowlers who are ideal for those conditions? I think Syed Ajmal, Sunil Narayan, Ajmal even more so than Narayan, is the best T20 bowler. Umar Gul is looking a little unfit, but again, someone who can come back and bowl well in those conditions. Someone like Sohail Tanveer, he can bat at the end. They've got a few sloggers at the end. So I'm just looking at Pakistan and saying, don't write them off. If you're looking for the X-factor players, there's a few X-factors in there. If you want to make a list of top 3, put them in.